So if I don't know you, what's up, beautiful? If I don't know you, my name is Mr. Murphy. I'm one of the senior Bible teachers here and part of the spiritual life team. Let's go, freshmen. Thank you. So I want to make sure that you guys always understand the reason that we're here. It's a simple phrase, right? Simple line. This is why we gather, because we are a community of concern on this discovery of faith. Let me say it again. We are a community of concern on this discovery of faith. That first part, community, because this is our people, dysfunctional as could be, but that's our people. This is our family. So we gather for the purpose of listening to the stories of our people. We gather for the purpose of listening to, again, what God is saying. So we are the community. We gather to listen. When it says we're the community of concern, because we gather to listen, but we gather to turn towards each other. We gather to turn towards, again, the one who is speaking. We gather to listen to the needs of our people so that we can respond. We are a community of concern on this discovery of faith. Discovery because we intentionally set out to explore what has been, what is, and what will be. We look at ideas, the good, and the ones that have some pretty harsh consequences. But we want to engage with a childlike wonderment, walking together to curiously find where God is at work. We are a community of concern on a discovery of faith. Faith, everyone has it. It's not a question of if you are building, it is a simple question of what it is that you are building. What it is that you are building. So we want to pull up some of the roots. We want to look at some of the beliefs that we have. We want to see if we can live under those. But make no mistake, we gather because we are a community of concern on a discovery of faith. So every time when we gather in here, let it be noted that we're trying to listen. We're attentively turning towards, again, the stories of the people. We're attentively turning towards God's story and how we might be able to join in. I invite you to join me in prayer. So, Father, as we gather, may we continue to look to you. May we continue to look and turn towards the people that are here, to look for the needs, to look in the ways in which we might be able to serve, that we might be able to love, that we can, with compassion and concern, turn towards each other for the purpose of honoring you. May you, again, give us a sense of curiosity, a sense of wonderment, a sense of deep exploration, of seeing again where we might find our great purpose in this world. And may we again do this so that we can build a faith that not only again survives, but thrives. And all God's people said, amen.
Woo! I see you! Yeah! Who's that? I see JoJo! Right on! Yeah, I see you.
Allen, I see you.
Clap it up. I see you.
I see you, bro. I see you.
Who we got over here?
Hey, we're not done. Keep pumping the music.
Yeah, we got to get that music going. Keep it going. Clap it up, everybody.
My mom. I see you, mom.
I see you. I see you.
Oh, Mr. Giovanni, I see
you. Come on, man, give me something. Give me something. Give it to me.
Come on. That was awesome.
Yeah.
I see you. Come on. I don't see my brother. Oh, there he is.
All right. Thanks, man. Whoa.
Wow.
I'm out of shape.
Yeah, I'm in shape.
Pear shape,
yeah. There's nothing like a 40-year-old movie to really get the kids' attention.
Jeez. The Dew right. Brothers.
Check it out. I better put my regular glasses back on. Hey, Jeff, you see what I see? Looks like we got the band back together.
Oh, gee. Where's my glasses?
We could see the movie better 40 years ago.
Holy smokes. Hey guys, I'm Jeff Dewey. I'm really, really out of shape. I teach history,
This is my youngest brother, Brad. He teaches the Bible. And we're on a mission from God.
Absolutely.
Hey, you know, I'm a little nervous because I just noticed Mom's back there. That's crazy.
She's over there now.
Is she over there?
I see you, Mom.
Hey, give it up for my mom, would you, everybody?
That's good. Hey, we're here to talk about something important. What are we here to talk about, Jeff?
We're here to talk about kinship.
Kinship, that's a fancy word. What does kinship mean?
Brotherhood.
Or sisterhood, right?
That's right.
Kinship is all about being family to each other. Kinship is the big fancy word, and that's what we want to talk about today. One of my core beliefs is that I think we all long to be seen and known, and that's true for faculty and staff as well as students. So we want to tell you a little bit something about us and our kinship as brothers. So how about top three moments as brothers?
Okay, this could be
our top three bromance. You ready? I am Loki in this relationship.
This could be a little difficult. Because there were many years where I didn't like you very much.
That's true.
That is a truth.
So top, number three bromant for me.
Yeah.
Remember when I was 2 years old?
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah, I don't. And what I heard about when I was 2 years old was actually from you. Our family went camping, and apparently there's a savage goat that was going to kill me and my other brother, Jeremy. And who saved me? My brother Jeff. That's the story he told my whole life. So top bromant number three, you saved my life. Thank you very much.
Yeah, we have a photo of like that time of our life. Let's see what we got. There it is.
Oh. I love bucket hats.
Mine aren't really bro moments or more impressions, but I remember that you cried a lot. And a lot of times, do you guys see him crying on my back there? That's truth. And a lot of times your crying got me in trouble.
That's true.
What's your second one?
Well, my second one was when I was 10. And do you remember our trip to Hawaii?
Epic.
Oh, my gosh. Everybody been to Hawaii? Anybody? It's super great, right? Well, my first time in Hawaii was also my first time on a jet ski. And I remember bearing down on the thing at 10 years old, going right towards this catamaran yacht. And I thought I was going to die. Until you intervened and saved my life.
I did.
Thank you for that.
We have a photo of that moment, too.
Oh, my gosh. There I am.
That's true life photo with my dad going, what? I won't say the rest.
It's high def for 1984.
Yeah. Number one.
Well, my top bro moment in my life, remember I was 13, remember our trip to Yosemite?
That was a great time.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, we went to Yosemite, had a great time, went out camping, and we have another brother, Jeremy. So Jeff, Jeremy, and myself, we all wanted to go hiking just out on our own. Bros exploring Yosemite. And I remember we had a fun time exploring until we got lost. And I thought we were going to die.
Yeah.
But you got us back safely to the cabin. So one more time, thank you so much for saving my life.
You're welcome. I actually got us lost, too, so I'll take credit for that. We have a picture of that moment, too. We took this self-timer shot right before we got lost. So there we are, Yosemite.
It's selfie 1986. It's pretty good.
So one of the things I remember about that particular moment is when we were scaling down that waterfall. That was freaky. And you started singing hymn songs because we thought we were going to die. And I always really admire your faith and trust in God. It's an inspiration to me.
Well, thanks for that. You always know when I think I'm going to die and I start singing the old Rugged Cross. If any of you grew up singing hymns, you know that song. Hey, Jeff, I need to tell you publicly, I was an idiot growing up. You all need to know that. I was not a great younger brother, but despite who I was, you saved my life countless times. And you always had my back. So thank you so much.
You're welcome.
That is what kinship is and what kinship does. Hey, we learn a lot about family, about kinship, about being brothers and sisters and sons and daughters in our family systems. And we shared a little bit about our life to sort of bring that to life. Another place where we learn about kinship, one of the most important places for me, is the place of Holy Scripture, a place where I sort of ease in and listen to the words of God for us about what it means to be brothers and sisters, sons and daughters in life together. And I want to tell you a little bit about this special place called Thessaloniki. Can you say Thessaloniki?
I like Thessaloniki.
Oh, I see what you did. I like Thessalodidas. Thessaloniki was this place in Greece. Can we give a shout out to George Matias? He's Greek. What's up, George? These are your people, man. And the Apostle Paul, super important early Christian leader, he traveled all the way around the Mediterranean and beyond telling people about Jesus. And one of his stops was this little town, this little coast city called Thessaloniki. And Paul stopped there and first thing, he went into the Jewish synagogues. He himself is a Jewish man and spoke about Jesus, the Messiah of his people. And here's the deal. Paul was like super compelling. And there's a lot of people that signed up to follow Jesus because of his preaching. But Paul wasn't done. He's like, listen, this is not a message for one type of people. This is a message for all people. So then he starts talking to all the Greek citizens, the Gentile people. And actually, this is probably where he did it. It's called the Thessaloniki Odeon, this old theater. You'd have plays there. Philosophers would show up and speak. And probably the Apostle Paul did too. And his preaching was so compelling that people started following Jesus too, and started becoming the church of Thessaloniki. We know them as the Thessalonians. Here's the cool thing about this church, Jeff. I mean, you tell me if you think this is cool. People of different ethnic, economic, cultural, and religious backgrounds, one people.
I think that's awesome. And I think what you're telling us is that kinship is not based upon biology.
Kinship is not based upon biology in the Christian tradition. Kinship is something that we can all share, that we can be brothers and sisters, sons and daughters to each other. Who are my theater people out there? Very nice. Now, who is your fearless faculty leader? Mama E, that's kinship. You follow? Right? Now, maybe some of you out there have adults in your life. Oh, he's like a father to me, or she's like a mother to me. That's all kinship. Kinship goes beyond biology. It's a much deeper reality. All right. Now, in just a second, Jeff's going to read to you a passage from 1 Thessalonians. I just want you to know something about the Bible. When we read stuff from the Bible, what we're reading is something that's been handed down from generation to generation because people think it's important. This is actually a copy from like the year 200 from of the passage we're just going to see in just a little bit. We're reading an ancient text that's been handed on. And here's the question I want you to think about as you hear my brother read this scripture. Does this text show a way of life worth living? Because if it does, then buckle up and join in because you'll have this life of abundant joy to follow. So here's the deal. 1 Thessalonians 5, 1 through 18. I know that's a big mountain or wall of text. My brother's going to read it in a second. But this is what I want you to know about this. This is the very first writing in the New Testament. This is the oldest piece of writing we have in the Christian tradition, and it says something to us. It's very important. Jeff, would you read that for us?
Yeah. Encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you are doing. Now we ask you, brothers and sisters, acknowledge those who work hard among you, who care for you in the Lord, and who admonish you. Hold them in the highest regard and love because of their work. Live in peace with each other. And we urge you, brothers and sisters, warn those who are idle and disruptive. Encourage the disheartened. Help the weak. Be patient with everyone. Make sure that nobody pays back wrong for wrong, but always strive to do what is good for each other and for everyone else. Rejoice always. Pray continually. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus.
Amen. The word of the Lord. Jeff? Anything stand out to you in that?
Well, there's some challenging teachings, for sure. encourage the disheartened kind of stands out.
Yeah, you got a story about that?
Yeah, I do. Seems like the hardest stories are the ones that kind of come first and easier, but here's a disheartened story that I experienced in my life. I graduated from Newbury Park High School right down the freeway, and I was not a very good student. When I graduated, really my main option of college was junior college, and I don't belittle that at all, by the way. I think junior college is awesome. It certainly worked in my case, but when I got there, my heart still wasn't in it, and my grades were even worse in junior college than it was in high school, and I ended up dropping out. When my friends started coming back from their college experiences on breaks and summers and telling me about it, I just felt like, gosh, I think there's something there that I kind of want, but I haven't really given myself a chance to get there at the four-year level. And so I went back to junior college and tried to rebuild my academic record. And I had a friend of mine who I played football with in high school who was at Abilene Christian University. And he encouraged me. He's like, just apply to ACU. You don't have anything to lose. And I was like, man, my GPA is just toasted. And he's like, just do it. So I did. And I got a letter of acceptance back sometime in the spring. My second go, and I was like totally blown away that this college said, "I see you. You're more than what we see on this paper with these configured numbers." And they gave me an opportunity, and I felt so like amazed that that could happen. I was blown away by the grace of that all. And then at the last paragraph of the acceptance letter, it said, "We immediately place you on academic probation," and they told me specifically, if you don't get a 3.0 or above, you're going to be exited out of the school. So I felt like I was getting an opportunity, but I was given very clear marching orders that I had some duties to do to honor their commitment to me. So I was disheartened and then filled up all at the same time in that experience.
It is amazing how we move from disheartened to encouraged when we're accepted. In this case, quite literally, college accepted. But we also have moments of being accepted by our friends and our peers. I'm glad you went to ACU because you came back with a sweet pair of rattle skin boots.
Those are cool.
Man, they were neat. For me, now listen, what we're looking at here is the pathway to kinship, right? The Apostle Paul talks about encourage one another. He talks about encourage the disheartened, help the weak, be patient with everyone, make sure that nobody pays back wrong for wrong, strive to do what's good. All of these are components of what it means to be kin to one another, the way families, biological or not biological, are ought to work. And when I look at this list, Jeff, the encourage the disheartened comes to mind for me too.
Yeah.
There was a moment in my life, it was about a decade ago, and I was stuck in what was just a fierce depression. Do you remember that day?
Yeah, definitely.
That day and age? It was more than a day. It was a long season in my life. And I didn't want to talk to anybody. I'd go to work and then come home and just want to be by myself. Wouldn't want to speak to anybody. I would go to church and I would sit in the back row with my family and I'd put my hood up because I just didn't want to be looked at and I didn't want to look at anybody else. It was just a fierce time of being low. Struggle with deep melancholy during that season. Until one Sunday night, sitting there watching a Broncos game on Sunday Night Football and there's a knock at the door and I'm sitting there like, who knocks in the middle of Sunday Night Football? I mean, my gosh. So I get up and I answer the door and there's my friend, Deb Bergen. Deb Bergen is God bless you, Deb Bergen, was a church fellow church member. She was a trained child psychologist, which meant she was perfectly trained to talk with me. And I open up the door, there she is. In her first three words, she looks at me, she says, "I see you. Do you want to talk?"
So you're saying this is not our theme. She literally said, "I see you."
Exactly. "I see you. Do you want to talk?" And in that moment, I had a choice. Say no and shut the door and enjoy the Bronco game, or say yes and we sit down in our kitchen. Thankfully, in my life, I said, "Yes, I do want to talk." Sat down, chatted for hours in my life. And that began this turn in my life, this thawing of melancholy and a return to joy in my life through that season of deep depression. Encourage the disheartened. It is one of the ways that we build kinship. All of these are ways that we build kinship. And I want you to notice something. Have you ever noticed like Christians that call each other brother and sisters? "What's up, brother? What's up, sister?" If that seems weird to you, it's been weird to people for like 2,000 years. What we're looking at in this text is like the first occasion where the Apostle Paul is referencing the Thessalonians as brothers and sisters. That's how they talked to each other 2,000 years ago, which is absolutely wild. So this bond of kinship, this formation of a new family, is this old way that Christians look at how we build fellowship in our life together.
That's good. That's a good lot stuff. Of encouragement one way or another in this passage.
Yeah, encourage is a theme.
Yeah, I think we should do that in real life here. We really don't want to just be speaking to you guys and having you guys attend something. We want you guys to experience something and participate. So let me kind of model this here. And then maybe some of you will be bold and courageous enough to be able to carry the modeling forward to somebody else in this room. Amy Krueger, where's our college counselors? Are they scattered around? I love you guys at College Counselors. I think you guys are unsung heroes here at this school. And I was having a conversation with Amy Krueger in the quorum in the history department not too long ago. And I just asked, well, what's the senior class like? What's your vibe? And she said this, the senior class is sweet and earnest. And I thought, wow, those are really great paired words. And so it got me thinking, there's people out there that I've had in my class that I just wanted to affirm. And so I'm going to call some of you guys out by name. KT, I see you, KT. And what I see in you is your curiosity. It's an amazing gift. And I hope it blesses you continually and other people. And you happen to be sitting next to Zeke. Zeke, I see you too. I see your charisma. If I could bottle your charisma and then inject it into me, I'd be amazing.
A lot more fun.
Yeah, I'd be a lot more fun. Your charisma, Zeke, is game-changing charisma. It's a God-given gift. Mm-hmm. Not everybody has that. And I hope it not only blesses you in your life, but it blesses other people. Let's see, where's Brooklyn Hanley? Quint Landis, Olivia Cameron. I can't see anybody, so where are you guys here? There you guys. You guys are amazing. You guys like spoke and wrote words in my class in which I stopped being like a teacher evaluator and I just like received it as a gift and as blessings. And I think you guys have like minds and hearts that meld together that are very impressive. Use those continually, not just to serve your own interests, but to the interest of other people. Let's see, who else is out there? Where's Gia? Hi, Gia. I know you hate this right now. Gia, your project, when you compared the Cold War to the Kardashians, still blows my mind. That was unbelievable. That truly was great. Let's see. Where's Safe? Safe. There you are. I always want people in my class speaking. And I, you know, for some reason, I think that's a high value. I do think it's great. But you have a quiet strength that I think is remarkable. And I think you should never change that. Let's see. Maybe two more. Chloe Johnson and Hannah Arrowsmith. Where's Kalani? Is Kalani here today? You guys are sweet, gentle spirits. Every time you're in my room, it gets better. I think you should keep carrying that forward wherever you go and bless people with that. What about you, B? Do you have someone you want to affirm?
Listen, we could do this all day. I look at a room full of amazing people, but speaking of, you know, sweet and gentle, I just always want to give a public shout out to Mr. Marcus Choi.
Yeah, right on.
Mr. Choi does so much work around this place in terms of helping us all abide within the rules, helping us all enjoy a safe learning environment. He does it with humor and great skill. Marcus, we started together here at Oaks several years ago, and it's just been a joy of mine to watch you grow in leadership and as a trusted voice on this campus. Plus, you wear Adidas, so that makes you really high in my book. I don't know what I just did. I sort of spaz clicked. So, anyways,
We need to move on.
Yeah, so listen, this is your turn. The Apostle Paul says, one of the things we do in kinship relationships is encourage those who do good work among you. My brother just set out what I think is a good model for what that looks like. And now it's your turn. We're going to come out to you. As my brother said, you're not just listeners, you're participants. And is there anyone that you would be willing to acknowledge and encourage for the good work that they're doing?
Am I still on? All right. Hey, so listen, guys, we could do that all day, and it would be really great if we could. But we're coming up on a time, and we wanted to release you guys and not go too long. But here's the deal. If you notice, we didn't have music worship today. And the reason for that is because that's only one aspect of worship. There's other aspects of worship, including what we just did right now, the spoken word. So the challenge for you right now, especially if you felt that was good and you want to keep it going, is that today, continue your act of worship by affirming and encouraging somebody with particular, powerful, life-giving words. Are you guys in? Because if you are, that's kinship. Go bless one another.
You are dismissed.